Welcome to this month's update. In the next few minutes, I'll be giving you a quick rundown of the latest new features and enhancements to Microsoft 365 with the goal of helping you get the most out of the service. Everything I cover here is fully documented in the transcript and resources guide available at aka.ms/m365update-blog. Now, on to the updates. Last month, I talked about how some of the new customizable mobile experiences in Microsoft Teams, while available to all, were of special benefit to first-line workers. They help the organizations where they work improve communication and collaboration while these workers are on the go. Building on that news, we're expanding Teams to enable more secure communication and collaboration workflows. Let's look at this new functionality through an industry prism. Priority notifications alert a recipient to an urgent message on their mobile and desktop devices and repeat the alert every 2 minutes for up to 20 minutes or until a response is received. Though this functionality will soon be available to all organizations, it can be particularly valuable in a healthcare setting. Here we see that a clinician has a time-sensitive situation where a patient's blood sugar is high. They send an urgent message to the physician on call via priority notification. The physician sees the importance of the message and responds in kind, ensuring the necessary care is provided. Had either person receiving the messages not replied immediately, the priority notification tagging means they would continue to be notified, until they respond. Another new feature, message delegation, enables a recipient to, you guessed it, delegate messages to another person when the intended recipient is unavailable. In keeping with the healthcare theme, message delegation could prove valuable in a scenario where a physician is going into surgery and arranges for a colleague to handle their messages. When someone, say a nurse, messages the physician, the nurse receives a reply stating who is covering for the physician and how to reach their delegate if the situation warrants it. It's sort of like Outlook's out-of-office feature, only different. With Microsoft Teams, people, including clinical staff, can quickly and efficiently communicate and collaborate in a secure, compliant environment that brings together messaging, voice and video calling, meetings, and apps into one hub for teamwork. Ever been in a meeting where someone has drawn a concept on a whiteboard and you want to grab a picture for later? Or maybe you want to save a picture of a meal receipt. Office Lens has been a great way to capture notes and info from whiteboards, menus, signs, handwritten memos, or anything with a lot of text. Now imagine the text you want to capture needs to be converted into data in Excel. You won't have to retype that data anymore if you're an Office Insider for Excel on Android. Simply use the Insert Data from Picture feature. Just open Excel on your Android phone or tablet and tap the Insert Data from Picture button. Next, narrow in on the data until you see it surrounded by a red border. Then, click the Capture button. If necessary, you can use the resizing handles around the edge of the image to crop it. Excel will process the image, insert it into a table, and give you a chance to correct any issues it discovered during the conversion process. Tap Edit to correct the issue, or tap Ignore to move on. Press Insert when you're done, and Excel will finish the process and display your data. And of course, saving it to OneDrive makes this new table available across all your devices. It seems like I have an endless supply of both personal and business tasks. Microsoft To-Do is what I use to keep track of them while on the go. It has a simple interface, syncs my tasks across devices, and integrates with Outlook. The newly added ability to attach files and photos to tasks makes it even more valuable. Simply open the task you want to attach the photo or file to, then tap Add a File. You'll have the option to add an existing file or take a new photo. In my case, I'll select the option to pick an existing file by tapping Device Files. I then select the content I want to add, and I'm done. Everything, including the attachment, will sync with my other devices and even show up in Outlook, complete with the file I added. Adding photos and files adds context to your tasks. Doing it from your phone supports your ability to be productive from anywhere. Artificial intelligence visualizations in Power BI use machine learning behind the scenes to reason over your data and surface insights in a very natural way. With the first AI visualization, Key Influencers, now available in preview, you simply select the key performance indicator for analysis, and Power BI figures out what matters the most in driving the metric. In this example, we want to understand what factors impact net satisfaction or NSAT scores. There could be all kinds of drivers, each having a different level of influence. The ones we are interested in for this scenario include manufacturer, country, and sale size. The key influencers visual tells us from the factors we selected, the most important influence on achieving an NSAT score of 7, which is good, is that the manufacturer is Litware Inc. To be exact, the NSAT is 2.64 times as likely to be a 7 as opposed to some other value when Litware built the product. And we see here all the way down at the bottom that a sale size of medium has a much smaller influence. Perhaps most importantly, changing NSAT to 1, which is bad, indicates that when sale size is large, NSAT is 4.32 times more likely to be 1 compared to all the other NSAT values. Armed with this insight, I can do additional analysis to try and determine why that's the case. As someone in the learning profession, I'm often trying to determine what influences the NSAT scores for my classes from a variety of factors like the region where it took place, the number or demographics of the attendees, the instructor, the day of the week, or even how much was spent on refreshments. This key influencers visual could finally help me answer that question. Maybe you can think of ways it might be able to help you make better decisions faster. The Power BI innovation train continues to run, and there is so much more that I don't have time to cover here. Be sure to check out the resources I provide, or simply visit powerbi.com to get on board. I've been using the Microsoft Authenticator app on my phone for a while to provide a second layer of security, commonly known as multi-factor authentication, or MFA. It supports fingerprint, face ID, or PIN authentication for both my Microsoft Work and Microsoft Personal accounts. And it works with other services like Facebook, Google, and GitHub. The Microsoft Authenticator app now sends you security notifications for important events on your personal Microsoft account. You can then view your account activity and take protective steps if needed. Here we see a message that my password has changed for my personal Microsoft account. I can let Authenticator know whether or not I made this change. If it wasn't the case, I'd click Not Me and the appropriate action would be taken. I'll select OK for this demo. Once configured, you'll automatically start receiving alerts when Microsoft detects sensitive or unusual actions on your account, such as changing your password, adding a new phone number or email address, or signing in from a new device or unusual location. These notifications give you a powerful tool to understand and keep control of your account. No word yet on when this functionality will come to Microsoft 365 work or school accounts. To get started, download the Microsoft Authenticator app and add your personal Microsoft account. Somewhere in the neighborhood of 99% of apps that worked on Windows 7 will be compatible with Windows 10 and Office 365 Pro Plus. But when your organization runs one of the 1% of apps with a compatibility issue, your transition to a modern desktop and all the goodness that goes along with it can be impacted. That's where Desktop App Assure, a Microsoft Fast Track benefit, can help. Whether you're moving from Windows 7 to Windows 10, a previous version of Office to Office 365 Pro Plus, or just a prior build of Windows 10 to the latest and greatest release, Microsoft will help eligible customers troubleshoot the incompatible application and suggest remediations. Desktop App Assure was a topic in the November 2018 Office 365 update when it was in limited release and is now available globally. Eligible customers should visit Microsoft Fast Track and select the benefit to get started. That's it for this month. As always, to get the most out of this update, be sure to check out the transcript and resources guide at aka.ms/m365update-blog. It includes the complete talk track and links to sources I used to create this video, a list of roadmap-related resources, and a reference of direct YouTube links to topics from past videos. I'm Jim Naroski. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again soon.